Does your law firm bill clients for time spent for distinct and different services? Well, then you need to know how to put service items on time activities when using QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. We may need to bill time based on hours of a specific service. It would be helpful to be able to put that item of service on a time slip or timesheet. This way, the hours of the specific service would be tracked to a specific associate's hours, as well as tracking the income on the profit and loss by client. Setting up for service items on time activity sheets is as easy as 1, 2, 3. First, we must input the income account into the chart of accounts that will track the income for that service item. Then we must input the item into the list of products and services and connect it to the income account that we just created in step number 1. Then all we have to do is activate the feature that allows you to add the items to the time slips or timesheets in the account settings window. So why would we need items of service on the time activity sheets that the associate attorneys fill out? Lana the lawyer in this example is a probate attorney. We wish to track our probate law income separately from the rest of our income. We wish to be able to put probate service hours as the name of the service that is billed in the hourly increments on both the timesheets that Lana submits and the invoice that the client receives. So first, let's put the income account into the chart of accounts, Income from Probate Services. In the top right, we click the cog wheel and then we go over to the chart of accounts. Then in the top right again, we click New. And of course, we choose account type, income. And the detail type will be service fee income. And the name, income from probate services. Click Save and Close, and now we do step 2. Input the item on the list of products and services. We'll call this one Probate Service Hours, $200 per hour. We click the cog wheel and then click Products and Services. Then in the top right, we click New. We double click for service. And of course, double check the name, Probate Service Hours. And we know that the income account is the one that we just created, Income from Probate Services. And the rate, $200 an hour. Now we click Save and Close. Now all we have to do is activate the feature that allows you to add the items to time slips and timesheets from the Account Settings window. So in the top right, we click the cog wheel. We go over and click Account and Settings. Now, the section that allows you to do that is at the bottom of the categories, click Advanced. Then scroll down to the section of the advanced category where it says time tracking. You have to click the pencil tool in that section to be able to edit this. And this is the other button in the time tracking section of the advanced category of the settings, where if we click this button, we will now be able to add any of the service items that are on the list of products and services to a timesheet or a time slip. First, we have to click Save in the section, then click Done. And now we're ready for our first example. Let's imagine on July 8th, Lana did 6 hours of probate work for Alan Arby. From the top left, we click New, Single Time Activity. Now the date of this event was July 8th of 2021. And it was Lana who did the work because she's the probate lawyer. The work was done for Alan Arby, and the specific service was probate service hours. It was 6 of them. Notice QuickBooks remembered that we put this in the items list as $200 an hour. And we can change it right here on the timesheet if we need to, and we can remove the billable if it's not billable. Now the number of hours is 6. Push Tab, and of course you would normally type in a description, or you could physically choose the start time and the ending time and put in a break and have QuickBooks calculate the number of hours for you in this case, and it would also calculate the money amount. But we will not do that. We will directly put the number of hours ourselves. So we click Save and Close, and now we check Reports and go down to Unbilled Time and click, and you can see this is unbilled time and it now has a money amount, $1,200. For the grand finale, we bill Alan on July 12th for Lana's hours that she worked on July 8th. And it's very convenient when it goes to the invoice. We click New, Invoice. The date is July 12th of 2021. And the customer or client in this case is Alan Arby. Notice as soon as we choose Alan, any billable time appears in the right panel and we can just click Add. And in 1 second, those specific service hours were added to the invoice with anything else we're going to bill Alan for. Now we click Save and Close, and you'll notice the unbilled time report is empty because we now have billed for that time. And when we click Reports and we go to Profit and Loss by Client, you can see in the column of Alan Arby, Income from Probate Services, $1,200.